You must take the pepper. Take the pepper and throw it over your left shoulder.
No, there's salt.
You must throw it over your left shoulder. Yeah. This is bad luck. It's not good.
No, is no.
It's not good. You must take the pepper and throw over. Quick, quick, quick.
Làm thế đi.
Sorry. It's okay. It's okay. No bad luck.
So we enjoy the meal right now?
Thật luôn đó, không phải giờ của nhà đi con.
You can enjoy I enjoy tour our meal in New Year's Eve.
In New Year's Eve?
New Year's Eve. Video Turkey.
Turkey?
Turkey.
Việt Nam dùng nào tay?
Kinh nhau.
Chicken.
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 And cake.
Chinese no cake.
I have some question for you.
In New Year's Eve, well, we have close to the same. We have a main dish, which is fish. Mm-hmm. We eat. I'm actually unsure the English words. It's a big fish. We eat everything. Which we eat with potatoes, and a sauce. Normal in Denmark, we have a really thick sauce. It's not healthy. We eat, and then at midnight, at New Year, we eat a big cake that's like a tower. It's a big cake. We eat and drink champagne. Yes. That's classic Danish.
And
what's your
one
for your
yes
in New Year's Eve?
Nói rồi. Vừa nói xong rồi. He just said. Có mà không không nói cả cá cả cá khoai tây soup.
So do you eat in Vietnam the turkey and the cake?
No. Chicken, not turkey.
Not turkey.
Big chicken.
Big chicken.
When you burn the chicken, big chicken, you look like the turkey.
Okay, you eat chicken and then you eat cake.
No, we don't eat cake.
No cake.
No sweet. It's a traditional, not cake.
Okay.
It's made from rice and meat and green beans. Have you ever tried this?
No, but I want to.
Yeah, this year maybe.
How about I see the sauce on the paper? What is it? Table. What is it for? Vietnamese family. What is it for, the sword?
In Vietnamese, we think in New Year Eve, we have a sword in the table to get away the god.
Okay. You use the sword for that.
So why did you tell them to throw the pepper on the left shoulder?
Yes, I told you in the start to throw the pepper to your left shoulder,
yeah,
behind it, because in Denmark we just have salt and pepper to season the food. So if someone is taking the salt, so actually just going for the drink and then accidentally, oh, spill salt on the table, it's like, no, 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 quick, pepper, and to your left shoulder, because it means bad luck if you spill salt. Bad luck, you won't have a good day. So take pepper and okay, no problem.
Vậy là ở Đan Mạch là người ta ví dụ trên một cái bàn tiệc mà người ta có muối, có gia vị là hạt tiêu ở trên bàn để làm gia vị đúng không ạ, có thể cho vào uống hay là để ăn gì đó, thì là khi mà mình lấy muối mà chẳng may mình làm rơi cái muối đấy ra, thì lúc đấy người ta nghĩ là nếu mà bạn làm rơi muối trên bàn thì có nghĩa là bạn cả ngày hôm đấy bạn sẽ gặp điều xui xẻo. Vậy thì bây giờ phải làm gì thì người ta có giải pháp là người ta ném luôn muối hạt tiêu vào bên vai trái của mình, qua vai trái của mình, thì nó lấy lại cân bằng, nó không bị gặp xui xẻo nữa mà là bạn lại có một ngày bình thường. Yeah, that is the story about that.
Another one characteristic that you see when you you're in party at a country, you might get the food for yourself in the whole party, right? Whole meal.
The whole meal.
Yes, but
for me.
In Vietnamese, when you have a guest, and we want to get the food for the guest, that means I will take the food for you, but I don't think that you like that, right?
it's different because...
We use the same stick for two people.
Chopstick.
Oh, the same chopsticks. So you actually give all food?
Yes, for every guest.
For every
we
guest.
We invite to the party, usually.
So if only one guest, all the food for one?
No, that's because we feed you, right?
You
feed
the guest, okay. Yeah. Okay, interesting.
But is that true in your country?
No, that's not true. We don't do that. When we have guests over, we cook extra delicious food. We have normal food which we eat every day.
Yeah.
And then if someone is coming over for dinner, we eat more food, extra food, food that takes longer time to eat.
Yeah.
Instead of just a piece of bread or something,
yes,
or rice or something, then we make a bigger dish. Maybe we make turkey, maybe, to put on the table. So we make extra food, make sure there's enough food, plenty of food for everyone to eat, especially the guests. So that we don't feed each other, everyone eats their own food.
But have you ever been in a situation in Vietnamese party, that's a vendor, the owner of the house, like that's get it.
I have actually been close to. I remember my first party. I was with at the downtown with some barbecue place.
Yes.
I was just sitting normally eating, and all the time there was five chopsticks. Yeah. All the time just putting food in my bowl. All the time. A lot of food I have not tried before. I mean,
yeah,
my bowl did not get even halfway empty, and it was already filled up. All the time. It's really friendly and how do you say, generous to do that. We're not used to that in Denmark, because in Denmark it's like everyone is equal. We have a hidden law called Janteloven that means you are not better than me.
Yes.
I am not better than you. We are all equal. So that way everyone eats their own food.
Yes.
Anything. So it's different when we come here to Vietnam, when if it then happens that everyone gives me food, it's like, it feels like I'm better than you, but I don't want to feel like that, because I'm just as good as you, are all just as good as me.
No, it's not only like you're better than me, just show the family.
No, exactly,
yeah.
But it feels to us,
yeah,
that we in the wrong,
yes,
position.
Yeah, I see.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So have you thought about the hygiene issue for that ritual?
Actually, no. I remember back in Denmark when I was told that everyone just takes on the same plate. I was like, okay,
Okay. Sure, mình hỏi Martin là bạn nghĩ vấn đề vệ sinh khi mà có nhiều đũa gắp cho bạn ăn như vậy không? Martin bảo là không vấn đề gì nhưng mà chắc là khó.
In the start it was a little strange, but it took me a couple of days and now it's just normal. So yeah, I'm not bothered by it.
Vậy là chúng ta thấy là ở Đan Mạch thì là mọi người quan niệm là ai quy theo đúng không ạ? Và chúng ta nếu mà ngồi trên một bàn ăn thì là tự phục vụ cái món ăn của mình. Tuy nhiên ở Việt Nam thì là khi mà chúng ta nhìn đến khách đến thì bao giờ cũng có cái câu là cái gì ạ? Nhịn miệng đại khách đường xa đúng không ạ? Chúng ta bao giờ cũng phải nhường đồ ăn cho khách rồi sau đó thì là chúng ta mới cảm thấy yên tâm và thể hiện là mình thực sự là đã quan tâm đến khách và đã hiếu khách đầy đủ đúng không ạ? Thì đấy là cái cách mà chúng ta có thể thấy sự khác biệt giữa hai văn hóa trong cái buổi ngày hôm nay ạ. So thank you guys very much for the nice role play and everything.
Nice.
So
we
have a lot of information today, right? And hope that someday we can invite to come to our house. Enjoy the party, right? So are you willing to enjoy the party with us later? So are you kind of willing to come to our house and enjoy the food with us?
Yes, of course.
So someday we hope to welcome Martin to the party.
Who?
So who wants to invite?
Who would you like to invite to the party?
I forget that. Who?